When we have these four Gospels, then we also have similarity and differences in these four Gospels. Why does each Gospel writer have different patterns in the writing? Pastor, will you throw some light into that?
Okay. Let me start with maybe an analogy from food. Okay. In India and around the world, we consume rice in many forms. We can just boil the rice. We can have biryani, which is popular in India. Or we can have some rice payasam, which is sweet. We can make idli or dosa with rice. We can have rice noodles. All this is made of rice. But they look different. By the time we have gone through a certain process, they look so different. Now, what would that mean when we are reading the Gospels? Think of that Gospel as rice. It is something that is common to all the Gospels. But the shape and the texture, the taste of each Gospel becomes different by the time we have the writing of each of these Gospels. Now, many of us, we tend to mix them up together. A classic example, during Christmas. Our Christmas drama most often is, we will see on the stage, the shepherds are there and the wise men are there. Both are there at the same time. Now, that's interesting because we know the shepherds are mentioned only in Luke's Gospel and the wise men are mentioned only in Matthew's Gospel. But in our Christmas drama, they have come together on the stage. They probably did not come together on the stage. So here we are, friends. We tend to mix them up. And the variety, God loves this diversity that is found in the Gospel. It's like a many-faceted diamond. Thankfully, there are four sides to the Gospel. So now, talking about similarities, not just in the way the stories are put, but also there are very strong verbal similarities. Example, if you look at Matthew chapter 3, 7 to 10, and Luke chapter 3, 7 to 10, these are the words of John the Baptizer. And remember, John did not speak in Greek, but these words are written in Greek. And we find that the Greek words are almost the same words. That means there is something going on here. So, gospel scholars have been studying the similarities, especially the words used here, and they generally have a certain view about the gospel, especially the first three. They are called the synoptic gospels. And the view is that Mark was most probably written first, around AD 70 or so. And then Matthew and Luke use this Gospel of Mark to write their Gospels along with other sources. And then the understanding is, the major consensus is that there is another set of writings or source called Q, German word Quelle, which just means source, that was used by both Matthew and Luke. So you'll find a lot of similarities in Matthew and Luke that has probably come from another source. But then Matthew and Luke also have their own sources. So that's how they put together. Now, this should not surprise us. I think sometimes we may have a kind of a magical view of how the Gospels got written, a magical view of inspiration. So because of that, we find similarities. We wonder what has happened. Luke has actually told us, right? I just read from Luke that there are sources. He's also using sources. And so they put together in this beautiful way, God has allowed the writing of the four Gospels. God's word has come that way to us.